look at the European market for June the 22nd, 2010. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Noon reminds you the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service, and I'm not going to make any trade recommendations during the course of the day, but what I will do is conduct some live fundamental and technical analysis, a bit of luck, we can put together some good positive trade plans. Please bear in mind that trading heavily leveraged is always risky, so I encourage you not to trade your hard-earned money until you have a good proven track record of success using your broker's demo. Okay, guys, well, I'm not going to take up too much of your time today. I think that we'll look at the euro and we'll relate that back to the euro pound. We'll call it good. A lot of these currencies look fairly similar in the way they're acting right now. So, anyway, here it is, right? Euro dollar. And I'm on board with the sort of the consensus out there right now that we're in retracement mode. And this is more or less what we spoke of last week. And in a nutshell, this is a daily chart I got you looking at. And in a nutshell, I'm looking for something a little like this. Alright. Going up to resistance. Down to the Fib of the rise. And then I think we're going to do a little something like that. And may even go as high as sort of 130. You know, somewhere in that vicinity. And then I'm going to look for reasons to short again. But it's not going to be... it's not going to be an easy process at all. You've got to understand that this is all still very counter-trend. Nothing has changed with the euro specifically. And, you know, I'm still very bearish on it. But I am sort of medium-term bullish on it. Okay? Now, the irony is, all right, is an important part of trading, is that I'm short-term bearish, medium-term bullish to long-term bearish. Okay, so I have three different mindsets as to which way directionally I'd like to see the euro go over the next sort of 24 hours, over the next sort of 3 weeks, and over the next 6 months. Okay, so today what I'm looking for is another little move down, because if we just take a Fib here of the rise, okay, and I zoom in a touch. Alright, there we go. I'm looking for something down in this area to long it, folks. Alright, in the vicinity of sort of 122 to 121.5 looks like a good spot. And if that lines up with the bottom of this range again, it's fantastic. That's almost going to look like a very, very ugly sort of head and shoulders there, inverted. But so be it. The dollar index actually looks a little bit cleaner, which is just the reciprocal trade effectively. It's not really giving us much of an edge. Gave us a bit of an edge yesterday as to where to short the euro, but it's not really giving us any new information telling us which way we're moving forward on that. But nonetheless, so if we switch quickly now to the 4 hour, alright, what I'm looking for in Asia now is a little something like this. Alright, I'd like to see Asia fade this back to somewhere in the vicinity of sort of 2360 or so. Alright, right back to this resistance. Okay, and then London kicks in, and I'm looking for that to be shorted back down to, you know, I think 22.5 looks like a good spot. And then that then starts to become the zone where I'm going to be looking to the long side of the euro. So I think that we could actually see a pretty good looking euro reversal today, meaning that we try to short it and then try to get long, and we might even finish up exactly in the same spot for the euro dollar today. All right, so be prepared for that. Now, if for some reason Asia just kicks us down, because lately, you know, when I started trading, seems like a millennium ago, we'd have a nice New York move like we had today, or a nice London move, you know, and then some continuation in New York, etc. But then you'd get the Asian fade, right, where Asia would see this low and then take you back to the central pivot. This is a weekly central pivot that we're coming off here at 2307, which was our profit target yesterday. So what Asia would typically do is then take us back to resistance, London would kick in and push us down. Well, lately we've been having to plan for different eventualities. Lately we've seen continuation during the course of Asia, which has taken us to support, right? And if you're at support at London Open, generally you reverse. Well, yesterday we were at resistance at London Open, therefore we saw reversals of things like the pound, to a less extent the Aussie and the euro, okay? So if we find ourselves down here at sort of 2260, we're not going down around Europe, all right? You've got to keep that in mind as to where we are in relation to support and resistance at a major market open. But that's the trade plan I'm looking for, a little short around sort of that 2360 and then trying to take that down 100 pips and then promptly reverse the trade and try and hold on to something to the upside. It's not going to be easy because you're going to have all kinds of people trying to short the Feb of this whole drop, and it's probably going to be in exactly the same place as we get short again today. So you got to be mindful of that in any long side trade. All right, the one other thing that's definitely going to be an edge for us today is the euro pound. All right, here is, let me get a cleaner conventional euro pound. Here it is, okay? And if I, and if we just go to the daily here momentarily, take note of what's trying to happen. This 21 EMA is pushing us down. However, we got all kinds of sort of higher lows trying to produce that's propping us up. And as a result, you got this problematic looking 4 hour, okay? And what I'd like to do here is just watch it as a trap, because if we break this trap to the downside, and we can see that the little blue line here is our 55 EMA, all right? And then we can see the highs, which is effectively the daily 21 EMA. We can just watch this as a little trap break, because a trap break to the downside there is a big sign, you know, and then we're just looking for a fib of the rise, okay? And that's going to give us, you know, that break to the downside will give us that euro weakness that we're looking for. And, you know, I wouldn't be surprised to see some buyers here, frankly, and then might even head all the way back up to 84.20. So that would also give us that short-term dollar or euro weakness followed by that euro strength, okay? And you've got to relate that back to your pound analysis as well as to how the pound is going to act in conjunction with this trap break on the euro pound, which looks like it will break today. This is getting very, very, very tight. All right. So my name's David Pegler. This has been a quick look at the European market for June the 22nd, 2010. Take it easy, everybody. Please leave me some feedback at YouTube or blog. Much appreciated, and we'll chat to you tomorrow.